Hi there, this is Tasha from PaintScout. Today I'm going to be showing you how to estimate a bathroom using time-based rates. So we're going to be estimating this bathroom here. We will be painting the walls a light gray color. So we're going from a pale yellow to a light gray, and then we're painting the trim, ceilings, and door frame. And those are all just going to be a white color as it is already. So this bathroom is 5.5 by 5.5 by 8. So I'll be showing you what that process will look like when you're estimating it in PaintScout. So you'll first log into your PaintScout account here. This is your dashboard that first pops up. You'll go into creating a new estimate. You'll choose your estimate type. For today, we're going to be doing an interior bathroom. So we'll pick interior. Of course, you can pick a template if you would so like, and that can have already some preloaded information in there, or you can even just do it from an empty quote, and I'll show you what that process looks like. So you'll first add in your contact. Our contact's name is Joanna. Then you can add in your job address if it's taking place at a different location, or you can just use the same address. Now, when you're building out your estimate, the first thing you're going to choose is between an area and a line item. For the sake of this bathroom, I'll be showing you how to measure it out using this area function. So you can have a couple different areas set up here with different titles. This is just a main floor bathroom, so we'll go ahead with the bathroom here. Put in your dimensions, so 5.5 by 5.5 by 8. The linear footage, walls, ceilings, and floor square footage will all be automatically calculated for you. Then we'll hit confirm. Now we're going to be choosing our different substrates or surfaces that we're painting. So we're doing walls, trim, ceilings, door, and door frame. So firstly, we'll go into walls here. And you can have a bunch of different rates set up for the type of wall that you're painting. These are just a pretty standard walls. There's not too much prep aside from, you know, filling some holes, sanding it down a little bit, washing the walls, but not anything too crazy. So we'll just do an 85 square footage per hour. If we go into here, you can actually see the breakdown with your amount of coats. You can always add in some prep hours, but for taking into account the little bit of initial prep and, you know, setup and cleanup, you can always include that in your rate here as well. And then you can always have a product attached and you can change it if needed, but you can have those products already automatically calculated. Hit confirm. And now one thing you will notice with this bathroom specifically, there is of course a sink and a toilet that's on one of the walls, but we do estimate using PCA standards, which states that if something's less than 100 square feet, realistically it's going to take just as long, if not, you know, the same time to cut around it as it would if, you know, you were just rolling and cutting and if it weren't there. So we're not going to take off any square footage. We're going to have to work around that still. So from here, we're going to add in our different surfaces. So we're also going to be doing the ceilings in here. Now, again, you can have different rates set up. These are just some textured ceilings. If you had flat ceilings, you might want to have a little bit of a different rate, but these will just take a little bit longer because they are textured. We'll add that in. Now, there's definitely going to need to be a primer coat on here because it is a little bit stained and yellowed. So to account for that, one easy way to do it would just be to put 3 coats rather than 2, and then your hours will be calculated accordingly. Of course, your other option would be to have your ceiling rate with the 2 coats of paint, and then do another ceiling rate with just the 1 coat of primer. And then of course your material cost would be the primer versus the paint cost. Go ahead and confirm there. Next, we'll add in our trim. So we are just doing the baseboards around there. And for the baseboards, they are a little bit chipped and kind of worn down. So we're definitely going to want to sand those and fill any holes, maybe do a little bit of caulking. So to account for that, it's not probably going to take too long, but we can always add an extra hour of prep along with the time it's going to take to paint it. So, and if you can always adjust that accordingly. If you think it'll take a little bit longer, of course, you can increase that. Then our last item here that we're going to be estimating is the door and door frame. So again, you can have different rates set up. This is a pretty basic door. It's not really stained or anything. It's in pretty good condition. So it will take probably about an hour 25 for the door and the frame. We're just doing one door, so that's what we'll put in for the quantity section. From there, all of your different surfaces are all included in there. And yeah, as I mentioned with prep and setting up, cleaning up, all of those sorts of things, you can always just include those in your production rates or add in extra prep hours. And we are brushing and rolling all of these, so that's why these rates are set up how they are. Of course, if you'd be spraying it, your rates might be a little bit different. Once you've added that area, as you can see, it's built out with your different surfaces you're doing. There's not too much detail here. If you would like to add a little bit more detail, you can click into your surface and go to this notes section. You can add any more specific notes if there's anything you want the customer to be aware of, or if you want something to make a note to just your crew. And this will only show up on the work order. It's not going to show up to your customer. And then there's always just some more advanced options for different elements that you can show your customer depending on how much detail you want to give in the estimate. And then it'll appear like this. So just a little bit more detail. And you can always include the color as well if you've already decided on it. From there, if you want to add in any pictures, you can always just click anywhere around the area. Go to add media here. If you're linked up with CompanyCam, you can pull from CompanyCam, or you can always just take a picture right on the site there. Once you've uploaded your picture, you can always add some notes. So this one is pretty discolored here, so just making a note for the customer and your crew. And of course, you can always have this show up on just the estimate, just the work order, or on both of them, just depending on, you know, who's it's really relevant to show the picture to. And from there, your bathroom is all built out. So if you would like to see more pricing painting projects using time-based rates, really PaintScout is the best software out there to do that. And you can always check us out today. The link will be below, and you can always reach out to us at support@paintscout.com. Thanks so much for watching.